Well, unfortunately, no snacks. We are now out of snacks, as I am also running out of sanity. Well, that's fortunate, Kelsang. Things are still a little bare bones here, I'm afraid, but we make do. No, there's no... nothing I can make use of there. Hey, Lamebot! Thanks for the follow. Much appreciated. Okay, go this way. Spooky Mookie. Well, it's not quite spooky yet. Give it a couple of months. Well, give it 1 month, and then it will be Spooky Mookie. In fact, it will be the spookiest Mookie. Okay. Don't mind me getting lost in this dwarven ruins. Yes. We beat up a wood elf to get it. Or, well, some of it. We raided a treasury to get the helmet and the cuirass, but we beat up a wood elf to get the rest of it. Akineko! Hi! And yes, Hogan J does apparently love me. Loves me enough to raid me. Oh, okay. You've come back. That's fair enough. That is the usual raid message he goes with, isn't it, though? Thought I had dealt with you previously. But yeah, the helmet on Spanks-the-Wayward here is not really one he's supposed to be able to wear. So the beast races are not supposed to be able to wear closed-faced helmets, and the ebony helmet is meant to be closed face. Yet for some reason, I'm able to wear this one. Oh, so you're palming your minions off on me then, Hogan. Fair enough. I'll whip them into shape. Or at least I guess I'll be babysitting them. At the very least, there we go. Glad I invested as much time as I have into acrobatics, otherwise I probably wouldn't be able to get out that way. Lovely, sunny... Hey, Kalsang, thanks for the follow. That's what I was saying. Lovely, sunny Mournhold. City of light, city of magic. Now, for the fourth time now, we head back to Vardenfell, and go back to Pelagiat. And thank you, Akineko. I hope I'm pronouncing that correctly. And I'm not going to make the same mistake I made last time. I'm going to actually make use of one of the items I have. And slow fall over this. There. Slow falling hurts a lot less, I can assure you. What time is it? 6 p.m. Huh. Yeah, we'll ignore the reality breaking itself issues over there. Okay. Akai? Aki? Akai? Forgive me, I am rubbish with names. Something you'll see a lot in this playthrough as well. I'm getting worn out by all the crazy dwarven ruin names and Daedra ruins. With far more consonants strung together than they should be. That's fine. Weebs are welcome here. I watch the occasional Chinese cartoon as well. My favourite being Corey in the house. Radok Stungthumbs is a nice enough name, yes, but when you also have to pronounce like six other dwarven names in a single sentence, it is a bit of a tongue twister. Yes, I do have those DLCs. Philosopher. And... oh yeah, I've already wiped you out. And AI use... so, Archai. Is that correct? Archai? And I don't know if it's a new rebirth version, but it is whatever the latest rebirth is. So I downloaded it, well, about a month before I started this playthrough. Voig? Is that, am I saying that correctly? Boyd, thank you for the follow. Really? accidentally misclick, pick up a lantern, and everyone in the city is angry with me. Oh, this game. And now it's just taken all my clothes. Boig. Okay. Fine. Looks like we are going on an adventure to the evidence chest. All because I wanted to pick up this one potion. Yes. I mean, I did just... Ugh. I should have paid more attention to what I was clicking. A pleasure to meet you. So, evidence chest, evidence chest. Where, oh where, is the evidence chest? I have three uses of my master lockpick. Goodbye, master's lockpick. Oh, but the journeyman's lockpick I managed to do first time. Well, thanks for the stuff back, I guess. Right. So, as you can see, most of my stuff is stolen. What? Did they seriously remove Helseth's collar? That was given to me. But I will put that lantern back, because that's just given me nothing but problems. Hey, I took these items fair and square. I went through a lot of lockpicks to pick up my full set of ebony. Well, two pieces of ebony anyway. We are now back on track. I have the pyroil tar that I was after. So back to Dwemer Ruins. Where's that spooky ghost? There you are. Radek, you find that pyroil tar, yeah? Yep. Yes, yes, I found it. Ah, that's the stuff. Here, I'll do this. There. There's your sword. Not a bad looking blade, actually. Good luck to you, youngster. Now, leave this old dwarf alone. Go. How much skooma do I have at any given time? I have no skooma on me at any given time. I have picked up one bottle once, realised what it was, and put it away again. Yeah, that's how they get you, B. It's you go on the heist of the century, and it's the one lantern that you accidentally knock over that they arrest you over. Okay. Is saying you haven't played Elden Ring. But one of the things you remember people talking about it in that was the in that game is that they wish there was a way to track quests. I always felt the Morrowind Store Journal would have been fitting for Elden Ring. I haven't played Elden Ring either. A bit of a hot take, this, but I am not the biggest Souls-like fan. I definitely think it's impressive what people do with Elden Ring, but it's not really the kind of game I play. The frustration levels are too much for me to handle, I'm afraid. But no way of tracking quests. That does sound like a bit of an oversight. And there's my banana flame. I'm only going to hold this. I am not going to wear this. So that's true flame. That's what it looks like. That's what it looks like when you swing it. And that is the last we are going to see of true flame. But yeah, if they don't have any kind of tracking for quests in Elden Ring, and from what I know of it, it's fairly open world, so it's quite easy to get lost in doing quest after quest. Yeah, something like the Morrowind journal or the Daggerfall journal, at the very least, probably should have that. Huh. That's weird. It's another perfect day. Would have thought they would have added a... What up? But then again, did they have a quest tracker in the Dark Souls series? Don't think they did they? So it would at least be in keeping with the other FromSoft games. Anyway, Alm Alexia. I've got the blade. The blade is reforged. The time has almost arrived. There is but one obstacle that stands in our way, though it pains me to believe it is so. Sothasil. I cannot count the times I have fought by the magician's side. It was he who stood with me the day I fought in Mournhold and banished Mehrunes Dagon to the depths of oblivion. It was Sothasil who was able to delve the mysteries of Kagrinak's tools. I hate those names. And raise me to the rightful to my rightful station. Now, though, the Tinkerer has become unstable. Quest tracker in the Soulsborne is the attentive player. Yeah. But the... Elden Ring is a special kind of open, though, from what I've seen. It's more akin to Breath of the Wild in its approach. So I can understand why people are calling out for a quest tracker of some kind in that game. Anyway, back to this. Sothasil, what? Do not concern yourself with Sothasil. Okay, we've heard that one from you before. So, you're saying he's become unstable. Once of the Sills like we are, the Lord of Vivek and I. He spent time among these mortals, instructing them, counseling them, protecting them from harm. He may have loved them more than any of us, though I do not know, I know not why. It has been many years since any have seen the sorcerer, though. Many more since he took initiates into his service. I believe he grew weary of mortal imperfections and retired to his Clockwork City, where he reshapes life, and some say the very world, into an image he finds pleasing. The Clockwork City? His lair is as puzzling as the mind of the sorcerer himself, ever moving, ever changing, its levers and gears responding to its master's will alone. It is here he performs his profane experiments, aided by his magic, tainted by his madness. I've suspected for some time that the Lord Sothasil had entered Tiogoroth's realm. His visits have been more and more infrequent and punctuated by violent fits of anger. He began to speak of the fall of the tribunal and the return of the old gods, but Sothasil is not a seer, he is a maker. He shapes the here and the now. While only I have been privy to what is to come, I know this. He's no longer the man he once was. And thank you for following Fwog. That's another rather amazing name. I do like nice, short, easy to pronounce names like that. So, the man he once was. He's completely mad. It was his creations, the fabricants, that attacked my city. This once great man is now a danger to Mournhold, and to all of Morrowind. He must be stopped, Spanks-the-Wayward. I believe it is your calling to stop Sothasil's mad schemings. I do not know that he can be reasoned with, Spanks-the-Wayward, but it is possible. If he cannot be, you must end his life. Though the idea saddens me, it is best for Morrowind, and it is best for him as well. You have the power to do this. The true flame can kill a god, if wielded by one of noble intent. Steel yourself, Spanks-the-Wayward, and do what must be done. I will send you to his Clockwork City now, if you are prepared. Good luck, Nerevarine. I'm going to need some time to prepare. I just need to rest up. There's not time to waste. Make your preparations quickly.
What may I do for you?
Return to old gods. As far as I know from Skyrim, the old gods are a dragonfly, bear, and fish. This part is pretty epic. Oh yes, yes, I do remember this part, philosopher. Okay, so we're quickly going to rest up in the Winged Guar. And then we're going to head off to horrible, horrible places. Right, beds, yes, please.
All right, then, I'm listening.
While I'm at it, I might as well put down a marker here. Just so that when I decide to recall again, I come back to somewhere somewhat friendly, rather than in the middle of a dwarven ruins. But now we are ready. I think. Maybe. What's the time? 12 a.m. Ugh. Just realised I'm carrying a lot of things again.
A pure reputation is wealth enough for me.
Right, we're resting again for another 7 hours. Are you serious?
Talk is free. What do you want?
These people.
What's your story?
Actually, no, we're resting for 8 hours.
On your way.
Then it's off to the bazaar. Sell the things. Then it's off to the Clockwork City. And I've got to stop this ash storm sometime. Do I think I'm going to mess with the survival mod for Morrowind? Well, first of all, I wasn't sure, wasn't even aware there was one for Morrowind. Secondly, I may do. That is something I do from time to time with the Elder Scrolls games, or, well, even Bethesda games. My first playthrough of New Vegas was the hardcore mode. Anyway, sell all the things. Except for that. Oh, you don't have any money. Fine, I won't sell all the things. So yeah, I'll definitely give it a go. When that'll be, I don't know, but but yeah, I do enjoy the survival mods for games. But that will be for another playthrough, I think.
Trust in gods and justice.
Okay. Fine. You're going to have a sort of gift. I'm going to put that in there. Because I really must be going off to the Clockwork City now. I need to give the Skyrim survival mods another look as well. I know I played with one that just messes with hunger and thirst, but I know there's one that factors in temperature as well. That might be interesting to play around with. Anyway, I'm going to stall this a little further. I'm going to have to go on a little break. So I'll save the game here. I'll make this stream save 20. And pause there. And go across to the appropriate screen. And yes, I will be away for about 5, maybe 10 minutes. So, as the screen suggests, grab a refreshment, have a chat, take a screen break, whatever you need to do. And I will see you soon. We have an adventure to the Clockwork City to go to.
Blessings upon you, my loyal servant.
Yes, I'm prepared to go. About as prepared as I can be, anyway. Then I shall send you now. Do what you must, Nerevarine. Why is she calling me Nerevarine? My name's Spanks-the-Wayward. So, here we are. Okay, I wasn't expecting that to actually work, but... very well. Into Vault 101, I guess. Just pull all the levers. And hope for the best. Again, apologies if sounds suddenly start playing really loud. Not much I can do about that, unfortunately. No. That didn't work. Okay. We'll try that again. That worked. Wary of all these beasties coming out to cause us problems. I mean, so far they're all dead, but inner flooded halls? Halls. Okay, well, before we go down there, what's this way? Nothing. Fantastic. Okay, well, that makes things easier. And there they are. Just the kind of beasties I was hoping I wouldn't see. I do like the sound effects they make, though, when they're hit. Actually, What if I speed? Don't mind if I do. No, oh, and of course both of them start moving. I'm getting closer to one another as well. We can't have that now. Gotcha. More fortify speed. Not that I'm making much use of it while stealthed. Okay. Might as well open everything up. This way is the supposedly less dangerous way, so I am definitely going to be taking this way. At least this way first. What do you open or close? Okay, you close that door. Very well. We shall open it again. And back to the corridor of doom. We'll aggro one of the beasties our way. Just as planned. Right, to the Hall of Delirium. That can't be good. We are now in a factory that makes sparks. We have officially entered a 1980s hair metal music video. Yeah. Little on the dangerous side, this place. I'm half expecting to find Sotha Sill just jamming out on a guitar underneath one of these spark emitters. Yeah, don't think I didn't see you. It's two of you. Very well. I will leave you be. I don't need to fight you. It just makes things easier if I do. Oh, what's this way? Yes, exactly. Yeah, giant stack of speakers. And of course I didn't enter the area stealthed, so I get ganged up on. Yeah, giant stack of speakers, long hair, and decked in leathers. Though something tells me Sothersil may not quite be the person I think he or remember him as. Ripper X57, yes! Yes, I am doing an unarmed build. If you type in !! conduct, you shall see the rules I have set myself for. Yeah, I don't think I'll be going that way for this playthrough. I'm stunning them by taking out their fatigue points. Basically, hand-to-hand combat works by working down your opponent's fatigue first, and then once you knock them down, you then start doing health damage to them. However, if you are a werewolf, your hand-to-hand combat actually starts doing health damage by default. And yes, one of the benefits of the hand-to-hand fighting in this game is you get to knock people down and stun them. And if you get lucky and get critical damage on them, as in you sneak up behind them and whack them over the back of the head, you can usually knock them down in one hit. And if you do that, you knock them down for twice as long as you normally would. Thanks for the follow, by the way, Ripper X 57. Well, there's a will, there's a way. Right, I better restore some of this lost health. Okay. Oscillating fabricant. There we go. That was an example of the one-hit KO. So there's a good chance that this fabricant won't stand up again. Yeah. There we go. So I have gone the wrong way. Very well. Thank you. Maybe I do need to go through the burning, horrible, wretched fire there. Just quick saving here, just in case. Ah, I can get through here. Okay. Yeah, I'm not falling for that twice. Wow, you bite. Well, hopefully I can take down this fabricant before the other one joins in. Oh, and there's another two. Oh, he's turned around. I don't know if that's a good thing or a bad thing by the looks of what's up ahead. But yeah, this kind of build works best in one-on-one fights. Although it can deal with multiple opponents, because I am kind of squishy still, despite wearing mostly ebony armor at this point, I have to make sure that all my opponents get knocked down before I start picking them off. And that can be a little difficult to do. But yeah, as you can see, once you start stunning your opponents, it doesn't really matter how much damage you do. You'll burn through their health bars quick enough. Okay, do I have any other health potions? I've got some magic potions, so... not that, at least. Yeah, I might as well use that. Huh. That looks somewhat terrifying. I have a feeling we may find, death number 7 here. Don't know though. I do have a fair bit of speed, so I may be able to time it right. Now these guys are offering themselves up for a demonstration of what will happen. Okay, so I'm going to save here and let it pass one more time. And get caught. It's number 7. I had a feeling that was going to happen. Okay. Here we go. Death number 8. So there must be a way to stop this. I can't jump this, no. I mean, I don't have the height. So there must be another way to do this, and what that other way is, I can't remember. Is there something I can do to attack this mechanism? I will? Well, I do allow backseating, but this is one where I may actually call for the help here. I can't remember how to deal with this. Let's see if some magic works. Well, it's not that. I'm not going to just burn through my magicka for nothing. No, that's not giving me any feedback. Nor that. I mean, it's not really a soft lock, seeing as this is the this is an expansion pack. But yeah, this is a bit of a dead end. If I can't work around this, well, if you don't mind me alt-tabbing, I shall go looking quickly just to see how to get through this. Right. Oh, that's an interesting... Levitate should work here. As would something else that I have. But it's going to get a little weird. Yes, I didn't think of this. There you go. Oh dear. So, there is a use for the scrolls of Icarian flight. Nope, nothing on those. Doesn't look like there's anything along there either. Okay, next area. Well, this looks deadly as well. Okay. Freshly minted fabricant. Interesting. And it's just pumping them out now, so... Well then, that's done something. Let's go in. Why not? No, nothing there. Okay, once again. I hate puzzles. I wonder if this works, or if it will trap me here forever. It will not. Very well. Onwards to the next area. Yep. Just a matter of baiting the door to open. And then opening up the other door behind it. Not exactly the most elegant solution, I don't think. There's probably better ways of doing it, but... Well, we got through, and that's what matters. Ugh. You just cause problems, aren't you? Yeah, I'm not letting you hit me. I know how much damage you do. Roughly. Okay, that seems to be it for this. Oh no. Don't like the look of this. Lever is rusted shut. You do not possess the strength to turn it. Hmm. Okay. In which case, let's see if this works. It does. Okay, that's a little bit elaborate, over elaborate, one might say. Very well. That's how you want to set it up. You know, while I'm not doing much, might as well start making use of my healing items. That'll be plenty for now, I think. And then all of a sudden, the grinding sounds stop. Ah, there it is. My word, that's a lot of beasties. You know, not quite as many as I thought there were. Oh, and of course you spot me. Not exactly the fastest creature in the world. Oh no. Oh no. Pity we can't have a mecha battle. Okay. Okay. Ow. Death number 9. Yes. Let's see if I can just sneak past this guy. Something tells me I can't, but I must try. I can't. Oh no. This is gonna be bad. Where was it? Oh, I'm already wearing it. Okay. Okay, well, time to fight, I guess. Wow. Oh dear. I have no healing potions left. Bit of an issue. Okay. Eat all the muffins. Ow. Not good. Not good at all. Oh dear. So what else do I have that might help? That could help later. I think I'm too close to rest. Oh, I'm not too close to rest. Okay. Yeah, that's a good call, actually. Rest until healed. Right, so I need to put the collar back on. I guess I don't need to, but the speed would be nice. What other shields do I have? Spell absorption. That will help. So would reflect. But I'll see if I can start off with some paralysis. I cannot. Okay. And that still hurts like the dickens. What? Oh. There we go. And that still wipes me out. So, paralysis does not work. Summon bone walkers, probably not going to help. I wasn't going to use conjuration for bringing friends to a fight. Okay, well, that could be useful, the scroll of slow healing. If I cast that at the start of combat, and then try and get stuck in. Try and follow it up with spell absorption. And then maybe shield. Okay, he's seen me. So, spell absorption, come on. And I think the... no, that's not as good as my spell shield. Oh no, it's the same. Okay, fair enough. But it lasts longer. Now, oh, that's a lot of pain. Yeah, that wasn't good. Right. Well, we seem to be at a bit of an impasse. I'll have a quick look at the wiki once again. Actually, which Dome of the Imperfect, okay. Yeah, it is magic resistant, as we found out. Yes, it does look like this is a situation where my build and my my restrictions, my self-imposed restrictions, are working very much against me. So, what I think I'm going to have to do is... I'm going to cast Mark here. Oh no! And I can't even teleport. Can I mark here? No. Oh no. I am indeed stuck with this fight. Well, I was thinking I should go back and train and get my magic up to snuff. So that's not going to happen. We are essentially trapped here. I'm going to have to think about this, unfortunately, so... Yeah. I'm going to save here, and it's going to have to be a stream, I'm afraid. So, stream save 21. So next time, hopefully I would have figured something out to deal with this situation I'm in. Anyway, for those of you on YouTube, take care and have fun.